Good morning, one and all. So in the last class, we have started with map rule and ML rule. So map means maximum a posteriori probability. ML means maximum likelihood rule. So I explained the difference between these two. As I told you, ML is a special case of map rule where we take all the symbols are equiprobable. So otherwise, ML is the upper limit of the map rule. So here, so this is about map and ML rule. These are very, very important rules. So when it comes to digital communication systems. So this is finally the map rule and ML rule for the generalized case. So we have to choose the maximum conditional PDF. Suppose, so for k equal to 3, so this is maximum. We say that the third symbol is transmitted. M3 is transmitted, something like that. So as I told you in the last class itself, so in the digital communication systems, we always deal everything in a geometrical domain. So that's why we'll try to interpret this ML rule geometrically. Okay. Now what does ML rule says? Set M cap equal to MI if the likelihood function is maximum. Okay. Now I will tell you what you mean by that. So what is the likelihood function? This is the likelihood function. So here there was a constant which we have removed because it doesn't affect the maximum or minimum of the likelihood function. Okay. So this is the likelihood function. So L of mk is maximum for k equal to I. Set m cap equal to mi if this is maximum for k equal to I. So we find out by varying k. We put k equal to 1, k equal to 2, so on some k equal to m. So we find out which one is maximum. Suppose if it is maximum for k equal to 2, what do you say? M cap equal to m2, which means second symbol is transmitted. So this is how we do the decoding of the sequences. This is called maximum likelihood decoding. Now, so here, now we want to represent or we want to interpret everything geometrically. What we do? So we do like this. Geometrically means signal space diagram or constellation diagram. So here, we divide the entire constellation into M regions. What are they? Z1, Z2, Z3, so on, so on, Zm. M regions. We divide the entire signal space into M equal regions. How we divide? So let us see. Now before that, so here, what is the ML rule now? So set M cap equal to MI if this is maximum. Here, see, please, there is a negative sign here. Okay, suppose if it has to be maximum, what I can say is, so this has to be minimum. If there is no negative sign, it has to be minimum. So L of mk attains maximum for k equal to I when this is minimum. Please, there is no negative sign, something like that. So if at all you want minus x to be maximum, then what should happen? X should be minimum, isn't it? So here we have a negative sign here. So if at all you want this to be maximum, so we need to get this term to be minimum without negativity. Okay. So if at all you want to get minus x to be maximum, you need to get x to be minimum. Okay. So that's why I am removing this negative sign. So if I remove the negative sign, it has to be minimum. The maximum becomes minimum. Okay. Now finally, so this is what the ML rule. Okay. Now it has to be minimum. So set M cap equal to MI if this is minimum for K equal to I. What is this? Can you guess it? What is this? This is the distance between two signal vectors. What vectors? Vector X and vector SK. So if you go back to the signal space analysis, you'll find out. We have seen this kind of formula already. This is the square of the distance between two signal vectors. What are they? Vector X and vector SK. What is vector X? It is a received signal vector or observation vector. What is vector SK? It is a signal vector. This is the square of the distance between two signal vectors. This is the distance between two signal vectors or two signal points. So received signal point and message point, represented by X and SK respectively. Now this is the square of the distance between two signal vectors, which means, so what we do here is, so we have to select the signal vector which is very near to the received vector. So distance is minimum, is minimum means what? Okay, so we'll see finally. Now now finally, geometrically, the ML rule is simply choose the message point close to the received signal point. That's it. Geometrically, it is very, very simple. So you have a m message points, you have one received signal point. What do you do? So you choose a message point which is very close to the received point. Okay, so we'll see an example. Now here what I am doing is, I am taking an example where m equal to 4, n equal to 2. What do you mean by that? So we have transmitted four symbols, m0 m1 m2 m3, let us take m1 m2 m3 m4. We have transmitted four symbols. How many? Four symbols. Now n equal to 2, which means we had only two basis functions. We have transmitted four symbols, but we represented those four symbols by using only two basis functions. Why? Maybe there are only two signals, there are two signals that are independent, remaining two are dependent, maybe something like that. So you know already capital M should be always greater than or equal to capital N, which means, so now we have a two dimensional signal space. Okay, this is a two dimensional signal space with a axis phi 1 phi 2, they are basis functions. Okay, now these are four message points. These are four message points. First message point, second message point, third, fourth. So these message points represent symbols, transmitted signals or symbols. First symbol, second symbol, third symbol, fourth symbol. Now these are fixed, they don't change. These message points will never change. Okay, so this is a two dimensional constellation of the given scheme. Now what I told you just now is, so before that I told you one thing. What do you do geometrically? So if you want to represent ML rule, we have to divide the entire signal space into m regions. Here what is m value? 4. So we have divided into four regions. What are those regions? Here what we do here is, we draw a line joining any two signal vectors, something like this. You draw a line joining any two signal vectors. So you draw a straight line joining any two signal vectors, something like that, any two adjacent signal vectors. Okay, now so here we have to take the decision boundaries. How they will be? They are perpendicular bisectors of line joining any two signal vector. Now this is the perpendicular bisector of line joining signal vector 1, 2 as well as 3, 4. In the same way, this is the another boundary, decision boundary, which is a perpendicular bisector of line joining signal vector 2, 3 and 1 and 4. Okay, is it okay? So this is the boundary. How to draw the boundary? You draw boundary should be a perpendicular bisector of line joining any two signal vector. Now we got these boundaries. This is one boundary, this is another boundary. Now what is the region? This is the region Z1, first region. This is another region Z2. This is another region Z3. This is another region Z4. We have divided the entire signal space into four equal regions. How we divided? By drawing the boundaries. How we draw on the boundaries? They should be perpendicular bisector of line joining any two adjacent signal vectors. Okay, so I will explain about these things in detail later, but so as of now just remember like this. Now so what this ML rule says? Okay, now remember, so we are representing everything geometrically, which means we are representing everything as a point and a signal space. Now we have four message points, they will be fixed. Now what is changing is x, the received signal vector will change. Suppose vector lies here, let us take the vector x is something, somewhere here. So the vector x is somewhere here, This is the received signal point. These are all four message points here. So this point is very close to first message point. Okay, so because the distance between this receiver point X and the signal point 1 is minimum compared to the remaining points. Otherwise, so this received point is very close to first signal point. Okay, otherwise it lies in region Z1. Then what do you say? We say that symbol 1 is transmitted. That is a ML rule. Simple ML rule geometrically. Suppose received point lies here. So what do we say? It is very close to the second message point. Otherwise, it lies in region Z2. It lies in what region? Second region. It lies here. Then what do you say? You decode or you choose. You say that second symbol is transmitted. If it lies here, the received point is here. Here it is very close to third signal point. Then what do you say? It lies in third region. Then what do you say? Third symbol is transmitted. So if it lies here, what do you say? You say that fourth symbol M4 is transmitted. So this is ML rule. I hope you like it. It's very, very simple now. So there is no mathematics, nothing. Just so you have to denote all message points and you denote the receiver point. So somewhere here. Okay, suppose if it is very close to the second message point, you say that second symbol is transmitted. That is ML rule. Why? Because, so what I told you, the distance between received signal vector and the signal vector should be minimum. So if it lies here, the distance between signal vector X and the second signal vector, sorry, the distance between received signal vector X and the second signal vector is minimum compared to the remaining three. So that's why we choose M cap equal to M2. So on. That's what we written here. So if a vector or if a received vector or observation vector X lies in the region Z1, then we choose M cap equal to M1. So on. But, suppose if it lies exactly on the boundary, sometimes it may lie exactly on the boundary. So now it is equidistant from first message point and second message point. Let us take. It may be equidistant from first message point and the second message point. Then what do you say? Either you have to choose first point or second point. Then what do we do? So if the observation vector falls on the boundary between any two regions, ZA, ZK, then the problem is resolved by flip of a fair coin. Which means we choose randomly. We choose either first symbol or second symbol. If at all it lies on the boundary between any two signal vectors, we choose any one randomly. Okay, because we don't have any clarity over that. But if it lies exactly inside the particular region, we say that so particular symbol is transmitted, corresponding symbol is transmitted. Okay, now here what I want to say is this is the simple ML rule geometrically without any problem. No mathematics, nothing. Okay, this is how the beauty of the geometry. Okay, now simply, so in order to find out the receiver structure, first of all you draw the signal constellation, indicate all the message points, so then divide into regions, equal regions. How many regions? M regions. If there are two symbols, two regions, four symbols, four regions, so on. Now, so decision boundaries and regions. So indicate vector capital X. If it is very close to the particular signal vector, we say that signal vector is transmitted. But remember, we may go wrong also. It will not be correct always. It depends upon noise. Okay, suppose. So if noise is very, very less, what may happen? You transmitted one, you may receive something like here. You transmitted this symbol, but you may receive this symbol. But if your noise is very, very huge, you may transmit this symbol, but you may receive this symbol. So just what I want to say is, it is our estimation. These are all estimations. they may not be correct always. If noise is very very huge, we may go wrong. These are not 100% correct. This is our estimation, this is a probability. Okay? We may go wrong also. So there is no such rule that it is always correct. But this is how we decode. Okay? Now, so this is about map rule, ML rule geometrically. Okay? Now, so let me go to the the decision boundary is a perpendicular bisector of a line joining any two adjacent message points. Okay, this is how we denote. Now, so just for simplification, for your understanding, receiver has got two blocks. What are they? Detector or demodulator and decoder. So this is a detector, this is a demodulator, decoder. Detector or demodulator, this is a decoder. Okay, now just for understanding, for your understanding, okay, but we'll see how to design the receiver of each and every technique. Now this is some receiver consists of two subsystems, I told you already. So detector or demodulator, signal decoder. So this is a detector, we have seen already, bank of n correlators. Okay, so decoder is based on ML decoder. Okay, so this is how I have explained already, please go through it once. Okay, now as I told you, so there are possibilities of getting errors. Now we have to find out what is the probability of getting an error. Okay, as I told you, so simply this is an estimation, it may not be correct always, we may go wrong also, then we may get errors. Now we have to find out what is the probability of getting errors. That is called probability of error. We denote with P of E. Okay. Now, so first of all, we may go wrong in the decoding only. Okay. So this is how we decode, ML decoding. What do we do? So we divide the entire signal space into m equal regions and we apply ML rule geometrically. This is what the ML rule geometrically. The error occurs when received vector x does not fall inside the region zi associated with the symbol mi. Okay, do you agree with me? Let me explain. So when the error may occur, when error occurs, okay, suppose we have transmitted first symbol. Let me take an example of getting an error. You have transmitted a first symbol. Okay, you know that. Let me assume that you know that what has been transmitted. So you transmitted symbol 1. Okay. Here in the receiver side, if x lies in the region z1, okay, what we decode, we say that first symbol is transmitted. Now, so you have transmitted first symbol and your estimation also first symbol, both are same, then there is no error. But so you have transmitted first symbol but vector lies in the second region, how we decode, what do you say? By our ML decoding, what do you say? If any received vector lies in region Z2, we say that second symbol is transmitted. But actually what is transmitted? First symbol. Now there is error. Another possibility. If vector lies in third region, if the received signal vector or observation vector lies in this third region, what you decode, what you estimate? We say that third symbol is transmitted. But actually what is transmitted? First symbol. Again there is error. Suppose if it lies in this Z4 region, what do you decode? You say that M4 is transmitted. Actually, what is transmitted? M1 is transmitted. First symbol is transmitted. Here also there is a possibility of getting error. Now, when you get error, simply in simple form, error occurs when you have transmitted first symbol, but your received vector does not lie in Z1. That is a generalized expression. I can say like that. Otherwise, here in this scenario, when you are getting error, suppose you are transmitting first symbol, and the received vector lies in Z2 or Z3 or Z4, you are getting error. In the simple sense, so instead of saying that if it is lies in Z2, Z3, Z4, you are getting error, we say that if first symbol is transmitted, there is an error if the received vector does not lie in the region corresponding to or associated with that particular symbol. Okay, so please remember, for a first symbol, what is the associated region? Z1. For second symbol, what is the associated region? Z2. Third symbol, Z3. Fourth symbol, Z4. Now, if you have transmitted first symbol, if X does not lie in Z1, there is an error. In the same way, if you have transmitted second symbol, if X does not lie in Z2, there is an error. In the same way, if you have transmitted third symbol, if X does not lie in Z3, there is error, so on so on. Do you accept it or not? You think about it. This simple logic. Okay? You try to understand this on your own. So, now finally, what is the error? Average error. How to get average? So, summation. I am talking about in general probability of error. Here, m equal to 4, no? M equal to 4, but m can be any value. We may transmit 16 symbols, we may transmit 32 symbols, so on, so on. Okay? I have taken only for example purpose 4 symbols. Okay? But, so we have to write m symbols. For m symbols. Now, summation. Okay? Otherwise, let me take this example only. Here, what is the probability of getting error? Average probability in the sense, what you write here is, average probability of error equal to, please pay your attention here, this is very very important. Average probability of error equal to, so probability that first symbol m1 is transmitted, p of m1 into probability that, what is that, x does not lie in z1 given m1 is transmitted. X does not lie inside z1 given m1 is transmitted. Now this is corresponding to the first symbol, plus in the same way for second symbol, what do you write? Probability of m2 into probability that X does not lie inside z2 given m2 is transmitted. I am talking about conditional PDF now. See, so here I told you already, given that M1 is transmitted, if X does not lie in Z1, there is error. Okay? Given that M2 is transmitted, if X does not lie in the region associated with the second symbol, that is Z2, then there is error. So same thing for third symbol and fourth symbol. So what do you write? Probability of M2 into probability that X does not lie in Z2 given that M2 is transmitted. So on for third symbol and fourth symbol. Now, but in general, what do you write? This is what you write. Probability of MI. Probability that X does not lie inside ZI given MI sent. So, summation. So, if it is 4, M equal to 4, what happens? P of M1 into probability that X does not lie inside Z1 given M1 sent plus P of M2 into probability that X does not lie inside Z2 given M2 sent. These are conditional. Why? Because I told you, given that M1 is transmitted, if X does not lie in the region associated with M1, that is Z1, there is a probability of getting error. Same thing for second symbol, third symbol and fourth symbol. Now, but we know that all the symbols are equiprobable. We assumed already. So what is the probability of each symbol? 1 by m. This will be 1 by m. Keep it outside. Now this is the formula. So this is average probability of error. What is that? 1 by m summation equal to 1 to m. Probability that conditional probability. This is a conditional probability. What is that? Probability that X does not lie inside ZI given MI sent. What is ZI actually? It is a region associated with MI. I told you, for each and every symbol, there is a associated region. For first symbol, this is the associated region Z1. For second symbol, this associated region Z2, so on so on. So for each and every region, there will be a associated region, namely Z i. Or otherwise, we can also write 1 minus 1 by m. If I write 1 minus, what happens? Does not lie becomes lie. Okay, negativity, I mean, complex. So complement, sorry. So 1 minus 1 by m, summation I equal to 1 dm, probability that x lies inside Z i given m is int. Now these are the two formulas we use. Either we may use this formula or this formula. Okay. So because sometimes it is very very easy to find out x lies inside Z i given m is int, rather than finding x does not lie inside Z i given m is int. Now we use 1 minus, you know already. So probability of one symbol is, let us take, there are two symbols. Probability of one symbol is 0.3. Obviously, what about the probability of another symbol? 1 minus 0.3, 0.7. Something like that. So I have taken 1 minus 1 by m, summation I equal to 1 to m. So it does not lie, becomes lies. Okay. Now, how to find out probability? It is nothing but area under PDF. I told you so many times. That's very, very important concept. So the average probability of error equal to 1 minus 1 by m, summation I equal to 1 to m. Now this is a conditional probability, is nothing but area under conditional PDF. Here, how am I finding this? X lies inside Z i given m i sent, means fx of x given m i integration over Z i. What is Z i? The region associated with m i. Now if you find out this, you may get the probability of error. So these are the three formulas. These are two formulas majorly we use to find out the probability of error. Either we may use this formula or this formula. You must know these two things, which defines the average probability of error. Okay. So there is no confusing at all. So even though it looks fully mathematical, but when you go into the geometrical, it is very very simple. Just finding a point which is very close to the received signal point. That is ML rule. Nothing more than that. Okay. So geometrically things will be very very easier. Okay. I hope you appreciate this. Now, so let us go to the BPSK again. So till now I told you everything for in general schemes, not particular schemes. These are all I explained for any general schemes. Now BPSK, if you remember, I hope you remember it. In BPSK, we are transmitted two symbols, namely 1 and 0. What is BPSK means? Binary phase shift keying, which means there is a phase shift of pi radians whenever there is a binary change in the symbol or bit. So S1 of t equal to root 2 eb by tb cos 2 pi fct. So that is nothing but root eb phi 1 of t. This is what we transmit for symbol 1. Now for symbol 0, we transmit minus of root eb into phi 1 of t. So this, since these two are s1 of t equal to minus of s2 of t, only one is independent, other one is dependent. So that's why we need only one basis function. Now these are the coefficients of expansion s11, s21. Here m equal to 2, n equal to 1. I told you all these things already. M equal to 2 and n equal to 1. M is always greater than or equal to n, capital N. Now this is the constellation having only one dimensional line. So these are two message points representing two symbols. They are EB and minus EB. Now what is the boundary? Now here, so till now we have done with the constellation only. So for this, we have to find the receiver. We have done with the transmitter. I hope you are okay with the transmitter. I explained in the last class itself. Now we are deciding for receiver. For receiver, we have two subsystems, namely detector or demodulator, and finally ML decoder. So to find out the ML decoding, what do you do geometrically? You take the signal space diagram, divide into M equal regions. Here M equal to 2 means 2 equal regions. For that purpose, we have to find out boundary. First of all, we need a boundary. See, you want to divide something. How to divide? You need a boundary, right? If you have boundary, you say that this is one region, this is another region. So how to find boundary? Boundary is nothing but it is a perpendicular bisector of a line joining any two adjacent signal vectors or message points. Since here we are having only two signal vectors or two message points, so these are two message points. This is a line joining these two message points, and this is a perpendicular bisector of line joining two message points. Now this is a boundary. What is this threshold? Zero. Why? Because it is root EB minus root EB. So what is the midpoint of these two? Zero. What is that midpoint? Zero. Now this is what? Zero. Okay. Now this is the boundary. We got boundary. Now how to get the regions? So to the other side, this side of the boundary, one region. This side of the boundary, another region. Now we call region Z1, this region Z2. Over. Two regions we got. What is Z1? It is from 0 to infinity. 0 to what? Infinity. So the first region Z1 is 0 to infinity. What is Z2? 0 to minus infinity. So we have got up to this. So constellation, in that we have divided that signal space or constellation into two equal regions. Why two equal regions? Because here m equal to 2. So since we are having two message points, so we have drawn the perpendicular bisector of line joining those two message points, and we got a boundary. And so from the boundary we got two regions, which means so to the one side of the boundary we got first region, to the other side we got the another region. The regions are simply a plane, maybe 0 to infinity, 0 to minus infinity. Over. I hope you are okay with this. Okay. Now we are, see, I want to interpret ML rule geometrically. I know ML rule, but so if I able to interpret this geometrically, things would be very, very easier. Okay. Now, so let us go to the PPSK receiver, coherent receiver. You know already coherent means, so there is a synchronization in the phase and frequency and amplitude. Everything should be synchronized. Anyway, in BPSK, we know already. S is XJ, we know already. Now, but n equal to 1, please remember, X is a vector having n elements. What are they? X1, X2, so on, so on, Xn. Please don't forget all these things. I cannot explain each and every time. So that's why I told you already, those signal space analysis is very, very important. So X equal to X1 because n equal to 1. So it's not a vector now. X is not a vector, it's a point now. Here there is no vectors now. Everything is a point. Signal vector is a point. Receive vector is also a point. Because it is one dimensional, right? N equal to 1. One dimensional means simply a point on a line. Now what is ML rule now? From this, what is ML rule? Can you tell me what is ML rule? If X1 lies in region Z1, we say that M cap equal to 1. Which means if X1 lies in region Z1, we say that symbol 1 is transmitted. If X1 lies in region Z2, we say that symbol 0 is transmitted. Or in simplest form, when does X1 lie in region Z1? Whenever it is positive. What is the threshold? 0. If X1 is positive, it lies in region Z1, then we say that symbol 1 is transmitted. If X1 is negative, it lies in the region Z2, we say that symbol is 0. 0 is transmitted. As simple as that. But if X1 equal to 0, which means it lies on the boundary itself, then we have to decide either 0 or 1. Now there we can't do now. We can't do anything there now. Okay. Now this is the ML rule for BPSK. Simple rule. Nothing more than that. Threshold is 0. That is very, very important. Why threshold is 0? Because you're taking the boundary is a perpendicular bisector. Bisector in the sense midpoint. It bisects this line into two equal halves. It happens, if I don't leave, it passes through the midpoint. So the threshold is 0. Simply you are comparing. See, so you receive x1, correct? You compare it with what? 0. If it is positive, what do you say? Symbol 1 is transmitted. If it is negative, what do you say? Symbol 0 is transmitted. If it is 0, you toss a coin. Randomly, you toss a coin. You say either 1 or 0. There we can't do anything. We cannot, suppose if x1 equal to 0, MLU doesn't work. We have to choose anyone randomly by guess. You have to guess it. That's it. Now this is the ML rule for BPSK. Very, 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 very important. You go through it once. Okay. So this is a region Z1 from 0 to infinity. Z2 from minus infinity to 0. If x1 is positive, it lies simply, it is just like that. It is a x-axis. This is 0. It is a positive x-axis, negative x-axis. If the x1 is positive, it belongs to the positive axis. Then we say that symbol 1 is transmitted. Otherwise, if it lies in the negative side of the axis, we say that symbol 0 is transmitted. If it lies exactly at the origin, you can't do anything. You have to say either 1 or 0. Randomly, you have to say any one. Okay. Now, this is what the ML rule for BPSK only. See, for each and every modulation schemes, ML rule changes. I mean to say, we have to choose depending upon the dimensions of this signal space. What happened here? In this example, here it is a two-dimensional signal space. There, what we got ML rule? Like this. So, observation vector X lies in region Z1. So, we have to verify what is the region Z1. This is a region Z1. Where is it? So, we have to check whether X1 lies in region Z1 or not. That is the case for that example. But this is ML rule for specifically for what example? BPSK. But the basic idea is same. But it is simplified version for BPSK. We'll simplify for each and every technique. Okay. See, what I want to say is, suppose the same example, it is like this. Let us take. I will take one simple sense. Same, two-dimensional. Okay. But I will change the message points. So message point is here, 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 here. Here, where are message points? Here, 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 here. Here, where are the message points? Here, 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 here. Now, what is the draw a line joining any two signal vectors? What happens here? Now, what is a perpendicular bisector of line joining these two signal vector? This axis itself. What is a perpendicular bisector of line joining these two signal vector? This axis itself. Now, in this case, these axes are themselves are acting as a decision boundaries. Now here, what is the region becomes? First quadrant is a one region. Second quadrant, these quadrants are themselves act as a regions. Okay. Anyway, so I'll explain this thing later. But so the basic idea of ML rule is same. We try to simplify it for each and every technique. Okay. Now, this is what the ML rule for BPSK. So no problem. Now this is a receiver. Okay. Now, so here, first of all, what is the detector? It's a bank of n correlators. But here n equal to 1, which means we need only one correlator. Isn't it? Because n equal to 1, one correlator. So I hope you are okay with this. I told you already. See, okay, I'll go there itself. Please, don't forget all those signal space analysis. If you don't know those analysis, it is very, very difficult to understand everything clearly. Okay. So it is waste of time now. Now this is the detector with a bank of n correlators. It is for a general scheme. But in our BPSK n equal to 1, which means this is what the detector or demodulator for BPSK. That is the first block. What is that? X of t into phi 1 of t integration x1. You get x1 only. So the remaining things will not present because phi 2 is not there, phi n is not there. Only we have only phi 1 of t n equal to 1. So there is no bank of correlators, only one correlator. Okay. Right. So without wasting much time, I'll go back to the BPSK receiver. Okay. Now what happens now? So that is the first block of the receiver. That is a detector or demodulator. How it is that? Something like that. X of t, phi 1 of t, root 2 by tb cos 2 pi fct. So integration 0 to tb. I'm writing tb. Please make your point clear. You get x1. Up to this, a detector or demodulator. What are next block? ML decoder. What is ML decoder? You just compare x1 with threshold 0. Here, what is threshold? 0. So you take a decision device, a comparator, you take comparator, threshold 0. If x1 is positive, choose m cap equal to 1. If x1 is negative, choose m cap equal to 0. This is ML rule. Now this is the ML decoder. This is a receiver. Over. So simply, PPSK receiver is having one correlator followed by a comparator. Simple logic. It's over. So this is the PPSK receiver. What a transmitter? I told you already. Okay. Now, so in the next class, we'll find out the probability of error of BPSK. Okay. Stop here.